Hey guys, Sai is here, and today in this video I'm gonna talk about how can you recover your device from boot loop. For example, if you flash any modules, no matter it is a Magis modules or kernel SU modules or Apache modules, and you flash that module and your device is gonna boot loop, so how can you fix? I will tell you three best methods. With the help of these three methods, you will recover your device from boot loop. So let's begin the process. So first method, which is a bonus method, this is not a method, this is a precaution. You can take it on your device. Like if you are going to flash any modules, so before going to flash any module, first you have to flash boot loop protect module, or we can call different type of modules is here, like anti boot loop module or boot loop protection module. So I will show you this modules. So as we can see here, it is two modules, which is a boot loop protection and other one is a boot loop module. So you can flash any one of this module before going to flash any other modules. Okay, so first flash this module and reboot once your device. After that you can good to go to flash any modules on Apache, kernel SU or Magis. Okay, so what happened? This module protect your device from boot looping if any module cause boot loop. Okay, so definitely take this precaution. And suppose if your device is already in boot loop, you not do these things and your device on boot loop, so how can you fix? So let's move on the first process. Okay, so let's move on first method. So first method is a recovery method. For example, your device is rooted with Magis, kernel SU or Apache, and your device is on boot loop. So first boot your device on custom recovery. Okay, so you know you need to use the combination keys to boot your device on custom recovery. Okay, so for in my case, I need to press volume down and power key at the same time, and when the device is on, the simply logo is schemes, then I leave this power key after that and hold on power down key, so my device boots in custom recovery. So I don't know what is your combination keys for booting custom recovery, so you can simply Google it on with the help of other device and simply boot your device on custom recovery. For example, I boot my device on custom recovery. Okay, now we need to delete that particular modules which cause boot loop. So where you find that modules? So simply, if you are using a custom recovery, which is TWRP recovery, then go on advanced, then go on file manager. Okay, so then you can need to go on data. So here it is, data, then go on ADB, and here it is, we have a module section is here. So click on this module section, and as we can see here, it is in my device two modules is installed, which is Zygisk LS Post and other one is Zygisk. So simply you need to go on that module. For example, if I want to delete this Zygisk module, I go on here and simply click on this right button and simply click on delete and simply swipe it, so that Zygisk module is deleted. As we can see, now you are good to go to reboot your device. As we can see, simply your device is rebooted and that module is deleted. So simply delete that module which causing boot loop, delete that module which you flashed lastly, and at the last time which module you flashed, which module causes boot loop, simply delete that module. Okay, so for example, if you are a custom recovery which is Orange Fox, so how can you do it? Little bit different this thing. So simply you need to go on this file section. As we can see here, it is, I'm on a file section, then click on this up arrow, as we can see, and as we can see here, it is the directory. So where we need to go, just click on this data option. Again, we need to go on this ADB directory, and as we can see here, it is a module section is present. So click on this module section, and here it is, the different type of modules is here. So which module you want to delete, simply hold on that module. As we can see, I want to delete this boot loop production module, so I am going to hold on this. So as we can see, this type of options is schemes, then click on delete button. So simply swipe it and go back. As we can see here, it is that boot loop production module is removed. So simply you are now good to go to reboot your device. So I'm click on the system. So simply you need with the help of this custom recovery, you can able to delete your boot loop modules which causing boot loop. Okay, now let's talk about second method, which is safe mode booting. Okay, for example, assume that my device is on boot loop. Okay, so simply we need to hold the all the keys at the same time until the device gonna shut down. Okay, so in my case my device is shut down, but I'm going to show you again. For example, I'm going to hold the all keys at the same time, as we can see. Okay, when so in my case the fast boot mode is came and power off option is here. For in your case, maybe these options is not came, maybe your device in your case maybe here it is a logo is on and off, your device oning on and off like this, your device acts like on and off like that. So on that situation, what we need to do, just hold the power key until any logo is came, and when the logo is came, just simply click this volume down button continuously. Don't hold this volume down button, just pressing volume down key continuously until the device is gonna boot it. Okay, so what happened when you're doing this, your device boot on safe mode. Okay, so when your device boot on safe mode, the modules are deactivated. Okay, so I will show you, just wait. So I am pressing volume down key until the device fully on. Okay, so as we can see, my at the bottom of the left side, the as we can see the name is here, which is safe mode. And now I'm going to unlock my device, and in safe mode, as we can see, all the applications are disabled, as we can see. And here it is the kernel SU. I'm going to open this kernel SU. It says download app disabled in safe mode. Right now, once your device boot on safe mode, that means you come out from boot loop. Just click on restart. I'm going to restart my device. So when you restart your device, the safe mode is gone and normal mode is games. And on that situation, what happens in safe mode, all the modules is disabled, and when you click on restart, the safe mode is gone and you are not in your normal mode, the modules is disabled. I will show you, just wait some time. So as we can see, I'm unlock my device, and you can see my device is turned on successfully and all the applications is appears. And just when I'm going to open this kernel SU, and when I go on this module section, as we can see, the Zygix module is deactivated. Okay, so in safe mode, what happened, the module is deactivated. So you came out from boot loop. So this is the second method. And the most important thing is, in my case, I need to continuously press the volume down key to came to inactivate safe mode. And maybe in your device, maybe for your company device, maybe the safe mode method combination keys is little bit different. So simply Google it on. You will know the boot keys of your device for safe mode. Okay, simply Google it. What is this? How to boot safe mode your device name? Simply search it on Google and you will get the combination keys. And after that, apply that combination keys on your device. And after that, you are successfully boot on safe mode and your device came out from boot loop. Okay, next talk about third method. The third method name is flashing stock boot IMG. Okay, so what happened? So simply suppose your device is rooted with patching method. Okay, so suppose your device don't have any custom recovery. So how you gonna root your device? Simply using patching method, right? Which is a patch method or maybe magisk method. Okay, so in this both routing methods, you can use patching method. So simply flash your device with stock boot IMG. Okay, connect your device with another phone or laptop and simply flash stock boot IMG. Stock boot IMG means without patched boot IMG. Simply flash that without patched boot IMG. That's it. And simply your device is boot successfully without losing data. Okay, so this is the third method. So these are the three best methods to recover your device from boot loop. Okay, from Magisk modules or Apache modules or kernel SU modules. If you like this video, then please like and share this video. See you in the next video, guys. Love you. Goodbye. Take care.